Before the video, I just wanted to say a big thanks for the overwhelmingly positive reaction to my previous video on the final scene of Succession. I've been making these things for years now, but they've never been as well received, so thank you. And if you want more, of course, all you have to do is subscribe.
Hey, Roman.
Yeah.
Hey, your dad is very sick. Very, very sick.
What?
As a screenwriter, after the initial shock of a scene wears off, I oftentimes find myself going back into it to analyze the pieces that made it so effective. And the one scene I keep going back to constantly from this year is Logan's death in episode 3 of Succession's final season, mainly because of how sudden and random it at first felt. Given that the show is about, well, succession, it was always inevitable that Logan would die at some point. But it was a surprise when it happened so early in the season and in such an unexpected way. Killing Logan off-screen on the plane is a bold choice to say the least, but it is not without very good dramatic or symbolic basis. The symbolic basis are the most immediately obvious ones. Succession is a show about the upper financial class of society, and one of the ways through which they distinguish that class from the rest of us is through the way they move around, which is with planes and helicopters. Already in the pilot episode, we get to see the entire family take off over Manhattan just to go play a simple game of baseball. It is of course ridiculously over the top, but that's not the point. The point is that these people live on a plane completely different to ours. They live in the skies, in skyscrapers, in helicopters, and in planes. And the key to the skies is money. So Logan's death in a plane is not random. It is symbolically meaningful because he dies in a world of his own creation, far away from the limitations of the ground which he has long since escaped. But the choice to kill Logan in a plane is also dramatically meaningful. A lot of times in Succession, things can feel like they're happening seemingly at random.
Yeah, Chef, you should probably know.
There's no great dramatic buildup for even the larger plot points.
It's me.
No lingering reaction shots like you see in other shows. But that doesn't mean that the placement of any of the important scenes is random. Succession does this because it is not a plot-driven show as much as a character-driven one. The response always matters more than the event. So in writing the event, the first question that the writers ask is when is the worst time for this to happen? AKA, when will it have the most dramatic value? A father dying of old age in a hospital bed surrounded by his loving family doesn't offer much. Kind of like if Logan had actually died at the end of the pilot episode. Which is why Succession carefully spends the first two episodes of season 4 establishing a worst-case scenario where the kids will have the most possible to lose from their father's passing. This is the main function of the club scene in the previous episode. In this scene, all of the kids are arguably the meanest that they've ever been to Logan.
Go ask him for more money.
But why?
Just good business sense. Gotta make our own pile.
Oh, come
right, Dad?
On.
Yeah, I mean, it's what my gut is telling me. So I gotta listen to my gut. It's all I got to go on.
Jeez. Despite still weirdly loving him somewhere deep down. They say the mean things under the assumption that they can later take them back and make amends. In the moment, these are simply the rules of engagement. But the regret that follows after they are stripped of the opportunity to apologize is very real and very powerful. Because Logan dies in a place that is utterly inaccessible to the kids, they are stripped of the opportunity for closure. Their momentary nastiness becomes the note with which they depart from their father, and the regret that follows is largely what defines their actions for the rest of the show and the rest of their lives. So although in the moment it may appear sudden and random, Logan's death is actually one of the most dramatically and symbolically powerful choices in the history of this already brilliant show. Thank you for watching.